for fame and lay with a model. Say my name until tomorrow. We can bang and rang and rang until tomorrow. Just a grand remains until the morning.
Hello, queens, and welcome back to my channel. It's Queen Esther of Queen She Me, and I just wanted to come to you guys with an update about my depression. You guys, if you are not aware, it is Mental Health Awareness Month, which is very, very important. It's something that we should all be paying attention to, not just this month, but every single day of our waking lives. Yes, literally. Why? Because so many of us are subjected to stress, and we do not even realize that a lot of us have a lot of these disorders, as a lot of the terms they like to put towards it, or diseases or diseases. And simply because we are always in the go of life, like we're just always go. So if you're new to my channel, I did do a very intimate video about my depression. And it's a long video, and I will leave it linked up above here and down below in the description box, so that way you can watch that if you want to before you watch this recent update. Okay, you guys, because depression is real, anxiety is real, stress is real, and life is real. And your life is very important. It's very detrimental to each and every one of us. Why? Because we are all connected. So when I see people, I always think of, you know, how they feel, what it is that they may be going through, because you just don't know what people are going through on a day-to-day basis. A lot of people just go through life and suppress their emotions, and that is not good. That is unhealthy, and I do not recommend or suggest that to anyone. So if you're watching this video and you feel like, you know, you're having unhealthy thoughts, or you don't feel like you are safe towards yourself or to others, I highly suggest that you talk to someone that you thoroughly trust deeply, or seek out some kind of formal counseling or therapy. Please make sure that you do take care of your mental health. All right, so now into my update on my depression and anxiety, you guys. So a few years ago, probably back in 2014 is when I finally did start to come about the idea of actually going to seek therapy out. In my previous video, I did mention, you know, about my mom and everything like that, and how throughout my childhood, now that I'm an adult, I'm able to look back and see that I was even then going through forms of depression and some forms of anxiety as well. And it's not my mom's fault or anything like that. I mean, it's just life and things happen, you know, but we all have to learn how to cope with these things. And so back in 2014, I entertained the idea of actually seeking a therapist, and I did. And if you're like me back then, or if you're just like a lot of people these days, you know, probably do not have health insurance, or, you know, don't know where to go or how to seek out these kind of services, I would highly suggest you go towards your local community, somewhere where, you know, it's like either a hospital or something like that, because they do offer services where you don't have to pay anything, or you pay like a small stipend, like literally. Like, and when I seeked out my therapist, I didn't have to pay for anything, thank God. If I did pay, I think I'm gonna pay like $2. So it was cheap, you guys, and I was able to get the help that I needed. And even still to this day, if I wanted to return to therapy, then I could if I wanted to. But right now in my present life, I feel so happy, and I have to literally say, like, I am happy within myself. And when I decided to go to therapy, I started going back in 2015, and I went for a few months. I didn't go like how a lot of people go for like a whole year and things of that nature, because when I really started going to therapy, she really was able to connect with me and to help me see things and to understand where a lot of my stressors and triggers were coming from, and that were actually, you know, playing a part of not only my anxiety but my depression as well. Because I was diagnosed as having anxiety with the onset of depression, meaning that when I have a high stress load, it can make me very, very anxious, because I feel like I need to hurry up, get it done, get it in place. And I'm just one of those people that is very, you know, punctual, and I try to just make sure that I stay on top of things. And then when I don't feel like I'm doing that, then I start to feel really sad. I start to beat myself up about it, feeling as if, you know, I just have not been in necessarily control of things. And we all have to learn that you cannot be in control of everything within your life. So yes, mine comes on with actually having anxiety, you guys. And then if my anxiety gets really, really bad, and if I'm like really stressed out and really, really anxious, then yeah, after a while your body is going to start to shut down and in a sense become depressed, because you have all these things weighing you down, all these pressures. So I feel right now in my present life, I am doing absolutely well, you guys. I have not at one single point in time have had to actually have to take anything from a doctor or anything like that. If you are not aware, yes, I do self-medicate. I do natural things as far as, like, you know, drinking teas or actually using CBD oil, which is legal in all 50 states. So there you go. So there are other alternatives to actually helping with your depression and anxiety if you do suffer with that as well. Also with me, you guys, I find that meditating, doing some form of yoga, and having some type of quiet time to myself is very, very detrimental for me. Why? Because I don't have to hear everyone else's conversations, everyone else's thoughts, everyone else's, you know, issues. And I mean, it's not their fault if, you know, they're going through it. And I mean, again, we do put ourselves in certain situations, but it is not my responsibility to have to hold on to those things or to always have to listen to those things. Because it's easy to let people dump on you when you're simply just trying to be supportive. And I mean, it happens to the best of us. So you have to learn to set healthy boundaries as well. So pretty much for me daily, I start my day at 5 o'clock, and the reason why I do this is because this is the quietest time of the day. This is a time where I have to me, to myself, because Alexa, she still sleeps pretty much until about 6 o'clock, so it gives me a whole hour to just pretty much either get up and meditate, do some form of yoga, to journal, do some crystal meditation, just simply talk to God, or if I want to, just simply just to lay in bed or to sit up in the bed and to just slowly let my body awaken to the day. Because so many of us, we just wake up and hit the floor literally running, and we don't even give our chance to literally reconnect with our body. Because when you are asleep, you actually do separate from your body, like literally and energetically, because you are actually restoring your physical body. And so your spirit man has that chance to actually, you know, disconnect, you know, have that time with God to actually, you know, build your spirit man up and everything, and you get to rest not just only physically but spiritually as well. And so when you just wake up from just, you know, a whole 8 hours of sleep and you don't give yourself a chance to reconnect, you're going to have a disconnect there. You're going to feel like you're all over the place, like you're still trying to get yourself together, because you literally are. So I figured that out when I decided that I did not want to have to seek any kind of formal medication from a doctor, because I have just heard so many just negative side effects. I have met people, you know, just by way of just conversations or whatnot, just by them just sharing with me, you know, about their own depression without me even having to share, you know, and they talk about their experiences with medications, and I do not want to have to go through that. I do not feel like my body should have to be subjected to that. But I realized too, through therapy, where I wasn't actually getting help in a sense from a form of medication. I had vices when I was younger, you know, that I would use to help me self-cope with my anxiety and depression. And one of those big things was definitely liquor. And I tell you guys, like, do not resort to drinking. It is not what you need to be doing, okay? You will literally just be drinking yourself to death. And I did that for quite some time. I did that early on, and thank God I don't drink like that now. I do have a drink, you know, probably once a night or however. We're all adults here, but it's not anywhere to the extent of how I used to be years ago. And so I just give thanks to God for that. And it just takes time, you guys, to get to a place to where, you know, you can start to let go of things, you know, that have affected you, people, relationships, loved ones, you know, boyfriends, girlfriends, husbands, wives, like anybody. Like, we all hold on to things that we still carry energetically within us that can affect us physically, and again, your mental health. So for me, as long as I make sure that I take care of me, make sure that I have set some healthy boundaries, so that way I don't feel like people are taking advantage of me or trying to use me or manipulate me in any way, shape, or form, then I know that I am okay. And it's not, again, about being in control, but it's about, you know, understanding your emotions, where they are coming from, you know, and not just always just being so quick to react. Because again, you just don't know, you know, what your triggers may be if you don't pay attention to that. And so when it comes to anxiety, you should really just be paying attention to what really stresses you out. And sometimes those stresses will last for a little time, just simply because you're trying to accomplish something, or, you know, satisfy a particular goal. And I know with me at that one point, it was school. It was school and work. And so that's all I did. I literally would go to school and go to work and then come home and spend time with Alexa or my friends or whoever. And back then, partying was my way of release. That was my way of expression. That was my way of just getting all the energy and feels out that I guess I couldn't verbally communicate. And so again, turn it to alcohol. So when you see where those patterns lie, then you're able to step in and correct those patterns. And it's very simple after a while once you begin to recognize that. So you guys, I just hope that this encourages you. You know, if you are going through, you know, depression or anxiety, what other healthy ways and tips do you, you know, refer to when you're going through your own, you know, depression moments and things of that nature? Because for me too, in conjunction with just using natural things and just being conscious of my thoughts and my decisions, I also go out into nature. Now, everyone does this differently. Some people go out to, you know, a lake, or some people might go out to a farm, or some people might just go out to the woods, like wherever that may be. For me, it's the beach. It's for me, it's being out in the sun. And as long as I'm out in the sun, I feel like that really helps to keep my mood and my attitude and just my energy overall at its highest. And because when you're indoors all the time, you do not get the nutrients that you need naturally. I mean, the earth and the sun and everything around us is here for a reason. We're all connected. So once I started noticing too, you know, I just started needing to get back out more in the sun, and not just during the summertime as well, because I started noticing too that I would have seasonal depressions. And people go through that, where when the seasons change, you know, the weather and the sunny days go to the cooler, darker days, you know, because the earth is starting to go into rest, into hibernation, you know, into rebirth, and, you know, going within. And once you start to realize that, you know, it affects you too, yeah, you can start to work on that. So, you know, it just happened to occur to me one day. I was in a conversation and I was just like, oh my gosh, I just cannot stand, you know, the fall. I was like, I can deal with fall. I was like, but the winter time, I was like, I just cannot stand it. And to be honest, this past winter or two have been one of the first two winters that I've actually been able to, like, you know, enjoy. And I guess it's just simply been because I have to understand too that we all have to do internal work, you know, in order to come out on the other side to see the light. So, you know, you can't have the light without the dark and vice versa. And so I started to realize that. And two, with me journaling and making sure that during those cooler months that I actually take advantage of those brighter days, it started to actually help me as well. So you guys, I feel that depression is something to where you just have to realize what it is that's affecting you. And then once you realize what's affecting you and sucking you of your energy, you know, and everything like that, you're able to start restoring yourself and healing yourself, so that way you don't have to feel sad, you don't have to feel down all the time, you don't have to feel like you don't want to get up out the bed or to go and do that fun thing that you love to do. Because for me, when I started really fully pursuing my passion and I realized what was going on with the transition of me losing my job so sporadically and having to be out of work for a year to finally coming back around to really get into the groove of things, it has been a shift within me. And I am noticing that, and it's for my betterment. And when you start to see that we all go through cycles and that it is a process and you have to be patient with yourself, then that's when you're able to start moving forward out of that depressive state or out of that anxious state, because you're releasing things, you're healing yourself, you're beginning to understand who you are and the people that are around you and why they're around you and why you do the things that you do. And so just simply start by journaling. Simply start by asking, you know, what makes me feel alive? What makes me feel like I thrive? What is it that when I wake up, I can't stop thinking about it, I'm passionate about it, and I could just do it every single day of my life? Whatever that may be. Some of us are artists, some of us are poets, some of us are dancers, some of us are, you know, lyricists, some of us are videographers and all other kinds of things out there. And you just have to simply understand who you are and tap into that and start living in your truth. And then you'll start coming out of that state of depression because you're doing things that aren't making you happy. So start doing things that make you happy. Start doing those activities and start being around people who really are putting back into you, you know, that love and that light that you need and that we all need and that we should all be trying to give back out into the world. So I hope this video helps someone out there today, because y'all, I'm just feeling so radiant today, and I hope you guys are picking up on that as well. I have really just been feeling good in that, you know, not every day is a good day for me, you know, but I know that I am better than the day before, and I know that I can continue to just be a better me as long as I start to, you know, just tap within, see what's making me upset, see what's making me feel off, what's making me feel anxious, and also to pay attention to your breath. Because I know I'm a fast talker, but I have to understand too that I don't have to be going so fast. So pay attention to your breath, you guys. Just take a second to just inhale and then exhale and let it go. That's all you have to do. You have to let go, let God, trust yourself, love yourself, and just be in your trueness. All right, you guys. So I hope you enjoyed my depression update. You know, again, if you have any more questions, please leave them down below. I do not mind answering them and then coming to you guys in a different video, or to share with you other things that I do, you know, like the tools, and or actually just seeing, I guess, my rituals that I do, in the sense that actually help to keep me centered a lot of days when, you know, I'm just trying to be my best. All right, you guys. So I love you, queens. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today, you guys. And I'll see you in my next video. All right. Bye, you guys.